Ready to say yes to more jobs with OmniDTF? This guide will walk you through the entire DTF workflow, from setting up your artwork to routine maintenance, all using OmniPrint's specialized printers, supplies, and software. With Omni's focus on quality and ease of use, you'll master the essentials for efficient and vibrant printing. Starting the machine. Leave the circulation switch on at all times. The pump will activate automatically when the machine is powered up. Make sure the ink level is above the minimum, the waste ink bottle is not full, and the duster has enough powder to begin your job. Ensure all clips are shut on the printhead. Now, power on the printer and let the pump circulate for 3 minutes. Turn on the vacuum setting and switch on the oven. Once the pump has finished circulation, open all ink clips and reposition them to avoid kinks in the lines. Click the printhead cleaning button, let it go through its cycle, and then repeat this one more time. Once complete, print a nozzle check to ensure everything is functioning properly. Queuing a job. Let's start by adding our artwork. Locate the Print Pro icon in the top left corner of the program. Click Open and select your file. Next, navigate to the Queue Rip window on the far right. Here you can size your image. Remember to lock the aspect ratio by checking the padlock icon. Now head to the Image menu and select White Underbase Choke. For this design, we're going to set it to 2 pixels. Now, let's create our layout. Go to Home and click on Open Layout. In the Layout tab, click New, then select OmniDTF. Several environments will be available. Each option here corresponds to different resolutions and white ink presets. Keep in mind, higher resolution options will consume more ink. Today, we will use the 720 by 1800 environment for a balance of speed and quality. This environment produces very crisp and detailed images. To add an image, simply double-click it in the Opened Images tab. Want more images? Click Ups in the Selected Image Operation tab and adjust the number of copies as needed. We can use the Queue Manager to rip and price jobs. Select your artwork and navigate to the Queue Manager toolbar. Click Add Job to begin. Run the rip by clicking the Rip Job button. To check the ink cost for your artwork, use the dropdown under Job Info. To save your layout, click on Save Location located in the far right column. Choose a location and go to Save Job in the Queue Manager toolbar. For future use, simply click Load Job in the Queue Manager and select your save file. Finally, click Print in the toolbar to start the printing process.
Shutting down the machine.
Close all ink clips and move the carriage fully to the left. Using a swab and the super cleaner, clean the capping station and the wiper blades. Once complete, fill the capping stations with super cleaner. Lower the flap on the front of the OmniDTF. This will give you extra room to reach in and clean the print plate. Do not clean the nozzle plate directly. Instead, clean the raised areas and the surrounding areas. In the OmniDTF software, click Wet Cap to return the printhead to the moist capping station.
Finally, turn off the machine.
Regular maintenance. For great prints, stick to a regular maintenance schedule for your OmniDTF printer. For weekly care, clean the encoder strip with a lint-free cloth and 70% ISO alcohol to ensure accurate carriage movement. For monthly upkeep, clean and lubricate the carriage rail. Use a microfiber cloth to remove any grime. Apply the provided grease to the carriage rail, then run the carriage back and forth to distribute the grease, wiping off any excess. Periodically, you will want to do a nozzle check to ensure that your machine is running optimally. Make sure your equipment is level, and use the OmniDTF software to print alignment checks. To adjust the vertical alignment, start by clicking Align and then Head Distance. Select Vertical and then End Check. Once the alignment pattern has been printed, ensure that the clearest line appears in the zero column. If it falls outside the zero column, add or subtract to the software number to compensate and click Save. Finally, print the pattern again to confirm the alignment. Repeat this process for aligning horizontally and bidirectionally. Make sure to check the right and left distance when doing a horizontal alignment. Once this process is complete, all of the alignment patterns should show a clear line in the zero column. And that's it. You now know how to use the OmniDTF software and maintain your machine. Happy printing!